Earthquake drills like this one are common in Taiwan. But on this day, they hold a special significance. They honor National Disaster Prevention Day and mark a grim anniversary.
Twenty-five years ago,
thousands of people were killed by a 7.3 magnitude earthquake in central Taiwan. It destroyed over 50,000 homes, damaged over 800 schools, and left communities without power for weeks. The quake's epicenter was a small town in Nantou County, and most seriously affected Nantou and neighboring Taichung. Over two decades later, memories of the earthquake remain clear to those who survived it. Dr. Hong Hongzhang was on shift in Nantou Hospital when the earthquake struck at nearly 2 a.m., not far from the epicenter. He still remembers the chaos and how quickly they had to make decisions about who to treat.
So, 基本上，那时候我们减伤会不是分一二三四级，没有，只分火跟死两个而已。那时候就忘记劳累，那环境就是抢救，然后再抢救。
With over 2,000 people dead and more than 10,000 injured, there was a shortage of critical supplies. Emergency workers also had to call for more coffins and body freezers. Water risked running out. So the head of the Nantou Fire Department remembers that when a winery caught fire, he decided to let it burn. In the end, he said, that decision served a dual purpose.
所有的街道都停电。 电力工全部停电，一片黑漆漆。刚好有这个光，它那个光很大，那个火灾的光，而且它在半山腰，那个光很大，所以它照亮了南投市、中寮乡，还有草屯镇，所以这个区域人心稍微安定。In
a neighboring county, some of the destruction from that time is still preserved today. Here in Taichung, this used to be a school, but it was seriously damaged in the earthquake. The fault line that caused the quake runs directly through this school, and all around me are damaged buildings. Since then, it's been turned into a museum where people can learn and remember. But it's also a reminder that people need to be prepared for future disasters. And in many ways, Taiwan is preparing. It's changed building regulations to protect against earthquakes and is upgrading an early warning system. But none of this can wipe away emotional scars. Lin Huiqi, who was a teenager at the time, is now a teacher at a school damaged in the 1999 quake. She said she's still afraid of the dark because of it.
当下一点多也是整个是黑暗的，我又看不到，我只能躺在床上摇，然后我听到旁边东西都掉，我又不敢就是起来乱走，所以就只能等爸爸拿着手电筒来带我出去。就之后只要一停电，我可能会比较焦虑。
Like her, many across Taiwan have their own stories of the earthquake. As the country moves forward in hopes of preventing another disaster, many continue to bear the weight of these memories 25 years later. Ryan Wu, Pichi Chuang, and Cadence Quaranta for Taiwan Plus.